أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نوين الأربعين، نوين الاعتكاف، نوين الخلوة، نوين العزلة، نوين الرياضة، نوين السلوك، نوين الصيام. لله تعالى العظيم، ما الذي أولياء الله عينون بعون الله، وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله. الله 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 كريم الله 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 عزيز الله 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 سبحان الله 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 سلطان الله أبدي سلطان أزلي سلطان الله الله ربنا ورب العالمين. ماذا دي أولياء الله عينون بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. الحمد لله. We are trying to be servants. That's all that is. We are servants whether we like it or not. We are عبيد. نحن والخلائق كلنا عبيد. والإله فينا يفعل ما يريد. The only difference with human beings is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us some additional abilities, ability to choose, the ability to accept or deny. Other creation, they don't have that ability. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything is compelled. The sun can say, I don't want to rise, or the moon, or the animals can, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is creating, can decide not to fulfill their purpose. Abadan. إِنْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. Everything is created is making tasbih, glorification, submission. ما في. إلا الإنسان. إنسان سبحان الله سبحانه وتعالى described us as ظلوما جهولا. Oppressor, ignorant. If he does not willingly submit Islam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is where this creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and this story of the human being starting with Sayyidina Adam's khalq and before that the creation of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before Adam was even molded into existence. Because human beings, they have the ability to carry the full manifestation. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create us and create jinn, who is going to disobey? Therefore, who is Allah going to forgive? اسم الله الغفار الغفور التواب. Who is Allah going to forgive? Who is Allah going to accept repentance from? The angels, they are compelled to obey. Therefore, the human being has the potential. إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. To be خَلِيفَةُ اللَّهِ فِي أَرْضِهِ. because of his ability to choose. And taking the choice of human beings is tantamount to killing them. الفتنة أشد من القتل. علماء التفسير, they say that the fitna here mentioned, fitna is worse than killing somebody. They say the fitna here is meaning to take away people's ability to choose. That's why Islam comes as a religion. Prophet ﷺ is not wants people to choose, but to choose على نور, على بصيرة. Say, reason, فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر. Whoever wants to believe, whoever wants to deny. But present to them the reality, the truth. This is the difference with Islam. Islam is coming to say, oh human beings, this is the reality of your being. This is what you are created for. This is the reality of your existence. This is the purpose of your... فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ. After that, you want to deny, deny. You want to accept, accept. I'm not coming to force you to believe. Allah is not in need of your belief. So tariqa is coming to teach what? To teach us how to be after belief, how to be better believers. After acknowledging servanthood, how to be a real servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what tariqa is. It's not adding anything more than that. It is the etiquette of the abd with his Lord. The adab. الطريقة كلها آداب. So a human being's adab, highest level of adab is Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Highest level of manners, أدبني ربي فأحسن تأديبي, is with Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. No one can attain that level of adab, because Allah is the one who taught him that adab. So, but for after that, never ending horizons of adab. وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ. Above every knower is someone who knows more. Above everyone who has good manners, all the way to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And in tariqa, before they can ask you to dress yourself with adab, with good manners, first you have to empty the bad manners. There's takhliya. It's before you can become a well-mannered servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before you take on good manners, you have to clean the bad manners. So takhliya is a principle in tariqa. Then tahliya, you come to the shaykh with all the things we are carrying, all the bad manners, the habits, and so forth. You're coming to the mashayikh. You are a Muslim, alhamdulillah, you pray, everything is... But you have attachments, you have bad manners, you have bad activities, bad habits that prevents you from the shaykh filling your cup with good manners. So before you the shaykh fills your cup, he must empty it from what you filled it in. And then there's where the awrad come. And the, what do we say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, rawatib and du'as and so forth that the different tariqas give to their adherents to the to. In the Naqshbandi tariqa, someone was asking about rabita and muraqab. The most essential practice is your rabita. After you accept bay'ah, the most essential practice, because Naqshbandi tariqa is not reliant on your achievements, on your abilities. So the shaykhs want you to be in connection to the mashayikh, your teacher. So I wanted to read today what Sheikh Adnan said about باب الرابطة الشريفة في بيان الرابطة وكيفية الاشتغال بها. Sheikh Adnan was one of the senior deputies and murids of Sheikh Abdullah Al-Faiz Dagestani, our grand Sheikh. Sheikh Abdullah Al-Faiz Dagestani left from Dagestan when he was young, because of at that time Stalin was collecting Muslims and sending to Siberia. So they went to Turkey, and the Sultan at that time, Sultan Abdul Hamid, with his Sheikh and uncle Sheikh Sharafuddin at Dagestan, he gave them a place about a couple hours drive from Istanbul. It's called Rashidiya. He gave them a whole area to live there, plant, have their zawiya, and then many people came and stayed there. Maqam of Sheikh Abdullah, Sheikh Sharafuddin Dagestani is in that area. And this is the place where Sheikh Abdullah did khalwa as well. He did khalwa for 5 years by the order of his Sheikh, in a cave in that area. If you ever go to Istanbul, one of the brothers there, he takes people to go visit, inshallah. He was at the age of 17, Sheikh Abdullah Faiz Dagestani, when Sheikh Sharafuddin put him in khalwa. Newly married, put him in khalwa not for 40 days, 6 months, 1 year, 5 years. 5 years khalwa. So, Sheikh Adnan and Sheikh Hisham were the two senior murids of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, and they met Mawlana Sheikh Abdullah. And Sheikh Adnan, he calls it wasiyah of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. He collected this in a book. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. He starts with يا أيها الذين آمنوا صبروا وصابروا ورابطوا واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون. The ayah in آل عمران that all you who believe be patient and صابروا is to exaggerate patience, to try your best, يعني not just patient but as much as you can. ورابطوا and have a ribat. This is where the rabita, the connection. وَرَابِطُوا has many meanings. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ means to the tariqa in Morocco, the zawiya, they call them ribats. Also from this meaning is where a person ties his intention, his ribat, to try to be a better servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they took the rabita, yarbut, to tie yourself, to connect yourself to the mashayikh, and from them to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, اعلم ان رابطة عند الصوفية اي عند الاولياء قد صلى الله عليه وسلم مطلقا هي نظر المريد بعين البصيرة الى روحانية الشيخ مع ميلان قلبه اليه بالمحبة الذاتية. He said, know that Rabita for the Sufis and the Awliya, قدس الله أسرارهم, in an absolute way is the murid looking with the eye of insight, not with his physical eyes, to the spiritual presence of the Shaykh, Ruhaniyat Shaykh, with love and mayalan al-qalb, with having that affinity, that affection, that love to the Shaykh. But for the Mashayikh in the Naqshbandi Tariqah, it has two types. One is to be in the Hudur al-Shaykh, when you are present with the physical presence of the Shaykh. And the other is when the Shaykh, أن يتوجه المريد مع المحبة الذاتية إلى قلب الشيخ بطريق التسليم إليه والاستهلاك فيه حتى يفنى عن جميع صفاته في صفات الشيخ. One is, as we said, when you are present with the Shaykh, to direct your heart, to direct yourself, to direct your being with love to the heart of the Shaykh, spiritual, with the intention of taslim, to submit yourself to your Shaykh. والاستهلاك في استهلاك to be disappearing in the Shaykh until you are annihilated from your own sifat, attributes, in the attributes of the Shaykh. This is when you are in the physical presence of the Shaykh. وأما ثانيهما أن تكون عند غيبة الشيخ, when the Shaykh is not present. This is where, and this is today's time now. Where Shaykh has murids east, west, north, south. Some can travel, some cannot, some can be with him, some cannot. What tariqah is based on rabita. You take the Shaykh, not just for teaching you alif, ba, ta. Suhbah of Prophet ﷺ was not only the physical teaching of the of Prophet ﷺ, but the states, the fuyudat, the mercies, the anwar, was moving from the prophet, hearts of Prophet ﷺ to the companions, not just what he was saying. That's why they say the suhbah of Sayyidina, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, hadith Sayyidina Hanzala, nafaqa Hanzala. Sayyidina Hanzala was saying, I'm munafiq, to Sayyidina Abu Bakr. He says, why are you saying that? He said, when I'm with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were tasting with their hearts. They were seeing some of them. They were experiencing. They were in that hal, in that state, in that mercy oceans that Prophet ﷺ was receiving. And some of it was going to the... So that is the suhbah. How else in 13 years in Medina, Prophet ﷺ came 23 years? In 23 years he took people who had no... were rough. They had the capacity to bury their own children. Some of the companions did. They buried their own daughters. And yet they became role models for humanity after that. Was it? So this is where the Sheikh is saying, is the second one is that you have to develop that connection to your Shaykh, whether he is present or not. And according, in the Naqshbandi Tariqah, according your ability to strengthen your rabita to your Shaykh, that's how much you will benefit in the way. And he said to direct yourself to the ruhaniyya of the Shaykh, until you experience al-ghayba or athar al-jalba, until you experience that attraction from the presence of the Shaykh. Aw al-ghayba, until you disappear completely from yourself in that rabita, in that jalba. When any of these two things happen, ghayba or jalba, then yatruk al-rabita, until you disappear from your essence and your attributes in his hay'ah, fi hay'atihi as-suriyah, in the hay'ah of the Shaykh. عِنْدَ ذَلِكَ يُشَاهِدُ مَعْ كَمَالَاتِهِ فِصُورَتِهِ لِأَنَّ كَمَالَاتِهِ لَا تُغْرِقْ رُوحَانِيَتِهِ. That's when you're able to witness the kamalat that the Shaykh is dressed with from through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. When you have that rabita to the Shaykh in the Naqshbandi tariqah, ruhaniyat Shaykh ba'da thalika is the ruhaniyah of the Shaykh will take over your tarbiyah, your spiritual education, إلى أن يوصله إلى الله تعالى فيكون من الواصلين الكاملين. That's your rabita to the Shaykh will make you move fast on the path. Without rabita, your awrad, your athkar, your, it's like the difference of traveling with speed train or airplane to traveling the old ways. Huge difference. Because with the first one, you're relying on your own abilities. The second one, you're relying on your connection to a prophetic inheritor. لأن الرابطة تدخل المستفيد تحت تصرف ولاية روحانية المفيد. When you intentionally direct yourself to and connect your heart to the heart of your Shaykh, you will be under the governorship of his ruhaniyah. And then he can have ifada from his ruhaniyah to your ruhaniyah. Now this might sound like science fiction stuff, especially in today's world. this is what rabita. But the simplification of this is your connection to the Shaykh. When you love somebody, for example, that's a connection. Whether you see it or not, it is a real irtibat. Huh? That person, even sometimes they're thinking of you. You, how many times you're calling somebody you love? They say, oh, I was just mentioning you. I was just thinking about you. You don't think there is a rabita, but there is a rabita, rabita tul mahabba. So one of the essential ingredients of a strong rabita is love and respect. Loving your murshid. You take bay'ah in tariqah with a murshid kamil, with a perfected shaykh. And that shaykh, now, you don't see him for a year. So your duty as a murid is to develop that familiarity. Learn about the mashayikh. Learn about the mashayikh in the Naqshbandi way. Learn about what they represent. Listen to the sohbas of the shaykh. Visit him if you can, as often as you can. All these things, what they will do, they will increase your love. They will increase your attachment to the Shaykh. And that will, when you direct yourself with mahabba to the mashayikh, that's when you can benefit most. So suhba, tariqah, he has suhba, the suhba in the Naqshbandi tariqah, the rabita in the Naqshbandi tariqah is essential practice. And he says here, أعلم أن رابطة هي نوع من المحبة. That rabita is a kind of love and respect. فمن لم يكن فيه محبة لم تكن فيه رابطة. The one who don't love the Shaykh, he cannot be in rabita with the Shaykh. That's the reality. So I saw one time Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, there was a brother from Cameroon. Cameroon? Africa. May Allah bless him. Abu Bakr. He stayed 3 years in Lefke. We used to see him when we go. I think he lives in France now. MashaAllah, he's 6'5", 6'4", six like that. Tall, big brother. And he stayed there and he was always in service. So they were building. Build, he'd go to the farms, he's always working, this and that, and he will come to the zikr. And at that time we were doing, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim was doing hadra with there, he would do hadra at that time, any brother would come. And he literally would, when he's in the hadra, you know, he would pick up everybody, you know, with his energy. He was so powerful. And also, you know, Africans, they have good rhythm. So I really loved having him in the hadra because he kept everybody. But I saw one time Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, he came, he kissed his hand and was standing there with Sheikh Hisham. And he kissed his hand and he says, and he looked at us and says, Abu Bakr, his love. He said, he doesn't need anything. Why? Because he was in istihlak, istighraq. You could see it on his face when he looked at Sheikh Nazim. He was in such ishq of Mawlana, of his Sheikh, that, khalas, you are in rabita. You are in muraqaba. If you have that type of love with the mashayikh, you are in rabita and muraqaba. And the Sheikh will take you to what? To have that love and mahabba and that ishq with who? With Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you're in that ishq and mahabba with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ahab. You are with the one who you love. So, like that, inshallah, you know, this is a sample, but this principle is in every tariqah. For those who are following mashayikh from different tariqah, right? These principles apply. Mahabbatul Shaykh will take you to hudur, will take you to mahabbat Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hudur fil Nabi, will take you like that. So you one container in another, until you reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's real love and mahabbah. That's what tariqah is. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding and grant us real love for Ahlullah. And you can love also any, if you love Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you would love anyone who loved Prophet. But then mahabbah that you have for your Shaykh must be something profound. So it is important to, for those who can afford to go visit, for example, for follow our Shaykh Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad, they should go visit him. For those who can have time to watch him on his tours, watch his suhbas, read his suhbas, also watch Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, his father, and his suhbas to Sheikh Abdullah, because it is a one chain all the way to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a sample. He talks about muraqabah also after this, because someone was asking us about muraqabah. We spoke a little bit about it. Muraqabah is only by the order and permission of the Shaykh. You don't do muraqabah on your own in the Naqshbandi tariqah. You don't do the muraqabah unless the Shaykh gives you idhn or orders you to do muraqabah. He sees you fit for the task. Muraqabatullah is to observe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that you're not heedless from your Lord. He says here, أعلم المراقبة نسبة زكية وعبادة صفية من تحقق به نور الله تعالى قلبه بنور المعرفة. It is and هي استدامة علم العبد. اعلم أن المراقبة هي استدامة علم العبد باطلاع الرب عليه. Is to be aware continuously that you are in Allah's, under Allah's observation. So muraqabatullah lak. Muraqaba is to raqib nafsak, that Allah muraqiba. Is to observe yourself that you are under observation. So not to allow yourself to go left and right. And this practice is by the order of the Shaykh in the Naqshbandi Tariqah. I know some people nowadays, they propagate meditation and muraqabah, but in the Naqshbandi Tariqah must be with permission. It cannot be on, I just want to sit and meditate. Tafakkur is something else. To sit, that's order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, says those who reflect upon my creation in order to perceive my magnificence, my ata, my generosity. That's something else. But to be in observation, that you are under observation at all times, must be with the authority of the Shaykh, inshallah. وإن الله التوفيق بحرمة الحبيب بحرمة الفاتحة.